Lineker, Andrade 2.
4 months we've been waiting on this.
John Lineker immediately closing that distance, looking to put those hands to good use as he's attacking the body of Andrade. Let's see if Andrade can figure out this puzzle that is John Lineker chopping down the legs.
Trading leg kicks, left to the body from Lineker.
Takedown, but Fabricio popping right back up to his feet. Lineker hanging on him. I like this early mix-in of the takedowns, Rich.
Yeah, this is what I was talking about because, you know, in the first match, Lineker basically depended on the takedown when he had to, but this time he's throwing those takedowns, and this is going to keep Andrade guessing so that he doesn't know whether he's throwing the punch or closing the distance for the takedown.
Beautiful little belly-to-back suplex right there, but Fabricio popping right back up onto his feet. Nice little drop down, attack the legs, but Fabricio's so hard to hold down as Lineker starts to let the hands go.
Lineker firing hooks into the body of Andrade.
Lineker wobbled right there in the corner. You saw Andrade's knees just buckle.
Look at Lineker.
And now Lineker just got wobbled.
Lineker unloading and then that stiff jab to the face of Andrade.
Andrade is doing a good job of utilizing that lateral footwork on his back foot. As he narrowly misses with an elbow attempt there. Lineker continues to push forward.
Andrade waiting for the knee, couldn't land it. Lineker counters back with a right.
You can definitely see the adjustments that Lineker has made in this match now. He's got Andrade thinking more. He's not completely in control, given it's still early in the first round, but definitely some good adjustments he's made.
Lineker cutting down the angles in the opening couple of minutes. Taking to the body of Andrade. Andrade with a low kick to answer, and then the body kick blocked by Lineker.
Yeah, but using the legs is going to be important for Andrade.
Right, and then the takedown again in the corner by Lineker. But quickly back to his feet again is Andrade.
Trying to go for the
unloading rights. Yeah, Lineker unloading rights, trying to get him count. Andrade sprawling. Can't let it go with a right and then a right knee. And a knee counterattack from Andrade.
I think we're seeing the strength of Lineker here on display, but he's got to be careful here because this kind of pace, when you're coming in explosively like that and then using that static hold kind of pressure, it can wear you down.
But Lineker's a vet, Rich. He's been in there a long time with some of the very best in the world. He knows what he needs to do to come into this match in shape to go 5 hard rounds. And you said it yourself, he expects to go into deep water with Andrade.
Agreed, but you saw that last overhand right that Lineker threw. I mean, everything that he does takes a lot of energy. Just stylistically, that's his style requires energy.
Chopping on that front leg is Andrade, and the front kick on the left.
Yeah, the front kick, throwing the toes to the solar plexus of Lineker. The body work of Andrade really paid dividends as the match wore on, just taking the wind out of Lineker slowly over time, and he needs to get back to that, utilizing those push kicks and those knees as Lineker tries to approach.
A lot of overhands from Lineker, and we saw that in the first fight as well, and a lot of that, of course, has to do with the size. The taller man is Andrade by a wide margin. There's a nice combination from Lineker on the way in.
Yeah, you see Lineker throwing those overhand rights, but getting his head offline while he's doing it, so he's making Andrade miss.
But Andrade didn't miss that knee.
No, he didn't.
Lineker did a good job of circling out on the first knee attempt, but now these knees are starting to connect. Lineker needs to get back to that movement. That's what he needs to do. He angled out immediately once he saw that knee coming. That's going to be pivotal to avoid those sharp, punishing knees of Andrade.
I didn't think about the challenge that Andrade has here in the ring because you have these 90-degree corners, and it's easier for Lineker to cut the corner and cut the ring off on him.
Oh, yeah, it makes a huge difference to trap Andrade in that corner. If he can pin him there and let go of some of those hooks, that could be the end of the night for Fabricio.
He's done it a couple times already.
Fabricio from Andrade there, 30 seconds to go, round one of 5, the bout judged as a whole.
Yeah, Brent, he's doing a good job of working underneath the chin of Lineker. Attacking the body, attacking the legs, trying to break Lineker down. But Lineker's just walking through a lot of these shots, but that right hand stuck.
Lineker, wow, he's in some trouble on his feet. Flying in for the knee.
Oh, that's it, he's on unsteady legs.
Andrade lands to the left.
He's hurt, he's hurt.
Round 2 begins, and the world title fight. And Lineker comes out of fire.
in a good spot. He does his best work punching people down. Trapping him in the corner and letting go of those hands. Oh, working the body of Andrade.
Ripping the body is Lineker. Opening 20 seconds have been good for Lineker after he was in some trouble to close the first. Shoots for the takedown. Andrade, good defense.
Yeah, that was a sloppy shot, Brent. He dropped down with his head. No setup on it. Lineker needs to set those up better if he wants to take down Fabricio.
Or even if he wants to fool him with the takedown.
Oh, nice jab by Andrade, but Lineker's using those leg kicks well. That'd be an important weapon if he can keep going back to those leg kicks.
1 minute into the second round of five, the world title in the bantamweight division. The rematch between these two, 4 months in the making.
I like the feints of Andrade. Getting a reaction out of Lineker, but Lineker shoots in, gets his hands below the hips. But Fabricio peeled up the hands. That was a really smart move to prevent Lineker from dropping down low.
Good hip work here. Wizard keep that pressure on, working the leg to the outside, defending the takedown.
Man, Fabricio's really hard to take down, and he's been able to get him down, but he can't keep him down, Rich.
This is the thing, you know, you guys were talking about this in the first round, all the takedowns. Me personally, I don't score those takedowns. Like, you have to not only take your opponent down, but maintain some sort of control position, at least for a given period of time.
He didn't control it fully there, but he unloaded some rights, did Lineker.
Drops down, puts the hands under the hips. Beautiful job by Andrade to fight the hands. He's got to get out this corner. He does.
Lineker throwing leather now back to the center of the ring. 3 minutes to go in round two. Overhand right from Lineker.
Lineker's wearing some damage on that nose. It's bothering him slightly, and it's coming from that jab.
The jab splitting the guard by Andrade. We've seen it a few times in this round. Combination there from Lineker on the attack again.
You know, Lineker let him off easy out of that corner last time because he's pretty much nullified Andrade's clinch work, because every time Andrade goes to the clinch, like that Muay Thai clinch, Lineker just goes downstairs to the body and starts unloading those heavy body shots.
Like how he's mixing in the leg work, chopping down those legs, taking out that support base of Andrade. But Andrade stinging him with that jab just over and over, touching him. Andrade's got Lineker on the back foot. That is not where Lineker wants to be.
You see the redness in the nose, some blood, a little bit on the face there of Lineker. He continues the jab, Andrade here. And a right, the counter right from Lineker, and then a left.
You know, initially Lineker was coming in and closing that distance, getting on the inside, but now he's kind of standing at range. He's gotten a little bit of success with the leg kicks, but this is that range where Fabricio was picking him apart with the jab last night. It was that range that made that shot kind of sloppy and gave Fabricio the ability to defend.
1-2 from Lineker, and then another left. Sending Andrade backwards.
Lineker slowed down a little bit.
Seconds here in round two.
One thing I'd like to see from Andrade, you see him just land that jab, he'll land another jab, but as he lands that jab, if he's not going to throw again, get out of range, angle off something so that he's not just standing in pocket, because he's taking unnecessary abuse from Lineker that he doesn't need to.
A lot of it's coming from that low leg kick coming from Lineker. I like that weapon. He needs to keep going back to it, but I'd like to see him set up with some hands, at least put a jab in front of it. Again, with the knee, this is Fabricio.
Lineker responding with left hooks. Left to the body, left to the face of Andrade. Andrade with a 1-2.
That right hand is a thing of beauty. Comes right down the pipe so fast, so accurate.
So
the two.
Straight.
So fast. Boom, boom, throws the knee, misses the knee. Beautiful circle out for Lineker to avoid the knee, but he got caught with the right hand.
Rich, how entertaining is this fight through almost two rounds?
Oh, this is beautiful because this is a nice back and forth action. I mean, I have Fabricio's in control of this match for the most part, but he, like I said before, he's taking this unnecessary damage, and that's not something you want to do against Lineker.
Andrade grew up as a kid, idolizing Lineker, watching all of his fights, and now he's got new respect for the man. It is bad blood between them.
10-second clapper goes as Lineker throws a two-punch combination. Fabricio trying to go up top, taking out these two, really putting on a show here in Lumpini Stadium, the iconic Lumpini Stadium.
That jab has been so effective and so powerful throughout the fight from Andrade.
I actually like when Lineker is using his jab. It's not something that we normally see from him, but he's popped that jab out right there. Jab landed, and it's really negating the forward movement from Fabricio in this match. There's another one.
Underrated weapons coming from Lineker are that jab and that low kick. Most of his knockouts are coming from those wide-angled hooks, but the jab and those low kicks help set up those shots. But Andrade, again, with those straight punches, that jab just working so well against the shorter John Lineker.
Into round three in his Bantamweight world title fight. Digging to the body again, Lineker.
Lineker in this round, he's really composed with his punch. He's not throwing so big that he's wasting energy, particularly when he misses and when they get blocked. Until the punches are coming in heavy, particularly the body shots, which is very composed with it.
One championship right here inside historic Lumpini Boxing Stadium. And putting on a show in this main event for these tremendous fans. Lineker and Andrade. A scramble there. Back to his feet is Andrade. And a left from Lineker.
Yeah, there's that. Any one of the adjustments that Lineker made going back to the corner was the utilization of that jab in this third round.
Definitely been the difference maker. I'm impressed with Fabricio. Like, Lineker's landed several 2-3-piece combinations, and Fabricio's just eating this stuff. And this is the guy they call Hands of Stone.
Yeah, and that's a clean left hook that Lineker landed, and Fabricio ate it like a delicious plate of pot thai.
He keeps coming forward, Andrade does, nearing the midpoint of this main event, world title fight.
Fabricio with that jab, just a trip hammer.
Triple jab that time.
And on that last jab, like, he landed that jab and then kind of lazily stayed there, and that allowed Lineker to return with the jab. And keep in mind, we're talking about Fabricio has a 5-inch reach advantage. Like, he should be able to hit that jab and disappear.
Side leg kick Lineker, and then he takes another jab to the face.
Yeah, but Fabricio saw that one coming. He was able to lean into it.
Fabricio peppering him with that snapping jab.
Lineker is just blocking all these jabs straight up with his face. Not the best defensive posture, but when you got a chin like Lineker, he's okay just to take one, just to be able to give one back. And there's that jab again, Rich.
Trading jabs. Good sequence here.
Man, this jam-packed arena is quiet. There's a hush has fallen over the crowd. They're used to seeing world-class strength, and they're getting another taste of it here today.
I want to remind you, when we were talking to Fabricio earlier this week, Brent, he said, what did he say? Inside three.
Inside of 3 minutes.
Inside of three.
Three rounds, I should say, yep.
I mean, after the success he had in the first fight, I think he's surprised that this match has gone this long, especially having Lineker on skates the way that he did in the second.
I'm sure. I'll just say this. The difference between the first match and the second match is I'm 100% certain that Lineker has earned Fabricio's respect at this point in time.
Oh, 100.
Final minute, third round. Big left from Lineker. Lineker with a 1-2.
The two connected, Brent. There's that knee right up the middle.
Step through from Andrade. 45 seconds.
Ooh, wow, that one hurt the eye. Fabricio winced ever so slightly as Lineker trying to put pause on Wonderboy. That's what I think Andrade needs to do, man. He needs to go to the body with those kicks. He needs to throw those knees. Right now he's getting a little boxing heavy. There's the knee.
Seconds. Heavy right, though, from Lineker on the counter.
Yeah, you can see Fabricio's right eye starting to close up over there.
Fabricio chopping away at the front leg of Lineker. Mixing levels, Lineker shoots.
Oh, that was telegraphed.
Lineker is back.
Beautifully timed from Fabricio to turn the corner and put Lineker on the back. That's a dominant way to end this round, Rich.
Yeah, it's just a great kind of matador style. Yeah. Missing that shot and ended up on top.
I like like the feints coming from Andrade here to open the fourth. Kind of freezing Lineker with some of these feints and then coming right down the middle with those 1-2s.
You know, one of the things coming into this was that in the first fight, we saw the best of Andrade as he takes a couple of shots here. Yeah, heavy artillery from Lineker.
That shot that took his balance, I think it just took his balance. It came over top of his head and threw him off balance. It didn't wobble him.
We saw the best of Andrade in the first fight. That was the theory, and we didn't from Lineker. And that's kind of being proven here in this rematch.
Yeah, Lineker talked about that. He talked about actually being stripped of his title and missing, and how that really psychologically took him out of the fight, and he just wasn't there. And he said, you haven't seen the best version of me, and I'm going to bring the best version of me. Now, whether or not this is the best version, I'll tell you what, this is definitely a Lineker 2.0 from the first fight for sure.
And that's talking about the reset that you documented in the open there, Mitch.
Yeah, I think that Lineker might not have taken Fabricio that seriously. He had a lot of hype and a lot of big knockouts, but he never really did it to a big-time opponent. And Lineker didn't really give Andrade the respect he deserved. And then to see him go back, make the adjustments necessary, refine the camp, and come out here with a performance like this against Andrade, who was basically just a one-sided butt-whooping, to be quite frank, in the first fight, it is really a true testament to what Lineker is all about.
3:15 to go in round four.
Stiff jab again, just touching, just scoring points is Andrade.
Yeah, I like the adjustments that Andrade's made in this round. He's doing a good job of doubling and tripling up the jabs. He got caught there coming out, but he's done a much better job of utilizing that jab and then and micro moving his way out, just like he did there without getting caught.
Beautiful combination. Andrade takes a heavy left throw in the ground for Lineker. And now on the run is Andrade.
Every time Lineker lands one of those big punches, you see Fabrizio's head just snapping. I'm wincing over here.
He continues to stand and trade, though. 2.5 to go in the fourth.
A lot of feints coming from Andrade off that line. I don't know if it could have been on the hip flexor or the groin. Not my call.
You know, from that angle, you don't know that maybe the knee actually hit above the belt line, but when the shin, sometimes the knee can flex and the shin come out and catch the cup.
The balance of Andrade on these takedown attempts of Lineker has been sensational throughout this fight. Oh, anyway, Lineker.
Yeah, we're seeing really good takedown defense from Andrade. His sprawls, his ability to see the takedowns coming. If Lineker wants to take Andrade down, he has to put hands in front of the takedown and then shoot in.
He needs to start getting some head movement in there just so he's not on line for these counters.
Lineker shoots again, and then slipping out of it on Andrade once again.
That was better, but when he entered into the single leg, he didn't transition to another takedown because he was able to get the single, but he should have went to a double, turn the corner, attack a little bit more aggressively. But that's easy for me to say, sitting 20 feet away from the action.
90 seconds in round four.
Wide angled hook landed by Lineker as he followed it up with a two.
Ooh, big knee, Andrade, then the body kick, and then the 1-2.
Straight right, left. Yeah, that left hand is a thing of beauty for Fabricio Andrade.
Yeah, and it cut Lineker open. He's got a cut above the right eye now on the eyebrow there with the bleeding.
Beautiful combinations again coming from Andrade. Counter with the left, Lineker, but he's taking heavy shots.
Andrade stinging him with that left hand as Lineker shoots in for another single, easily defended from Fabricio.
Blood coming from the nose and the right eye of John Lineker. Takes another heavy shot.
Lineker's hurt here. Lineker's hurt.
He's not seeing well as Lineker. Can he survive the final 40 seconds in round four?
Lineker just needs a little bit of space. Utilize the jab. Keep his hands up and get moving. Fabricio's hunting for that knockout.
30 seconds.
Yeah, that cuts right in the corner of the eye there. You can see the blood actually trickling down on his cheek and on Lineker's chest, but it's not impairing the vision, and Herb Dean has a close eye on that, I'm sure.
Uppercut on Andrade. Counter left from Lineker.
But this is Lineker now in the corner. This is kind of a desperation, and we're inside the 10-second call here. Once again, he's going to get saved by the bell.
Blood down the face, the nose, and the right side of the face. And now the body
touching him up. Good work by Wonder Boy.
Alex,
seconds out. I'll say this, Rich, for a lot of reasons, but especially the way the first one ended with just kind of a thud. Very disappointing. This one, to me, has lived
that's
up
it.
To the
billing. Wait a minute, that's it.
That's all. They ended after four rounds.
Lineker didn't answer the call in the fifth round.
Lineker did not answer the bell, and Fabricio Andrade is indeed the world champion in the bantamweight division here in one.
Wow. Listen, much earned, you know, especially there were two rounds there where Lineker was saved by the bell, particularly in that fourth round there. He was fading. I don't see him coming back from that particular fade at that point in time.
Are you surprised he didn't get off the stool?
Well, I mean, I'll say this, yes, I am, but I don't know what the issue was in the corner. Perhaps he was actually having trouble seeing. And if he can't see, then coming out is just pure stupidity.
Mutual respect for two men that have traded bars, particularly from Andrade over the last 4 months and leading into the first fight as well.
Yeah, I actually just got word that Alex's corner man is the one who stopped the match.
Saving his fighter from himself. We hear it all the time.
That's what your corner men, your doctors, the commissioners, all these people that are involved in these things, that's what they're for.
So Lineker on.
Spoke about the muscle that Andrade's added, but this is the best shape I've ever seen Quan Juan Il in. And Andrade immediately comes out in that southpaw stance and starts firing those left kicks, but Quan is right in his face, utilizing that jab, and that's what he needs to do. He needs to earn that respect. Andrade keeps his chin up high in the air like that, so I'd like to see it get tested. And Quan Juan Il just start to touch him over and over again, because Quan Juan Il has had his chin tested, and we know he can take a shot.
Jab two from Quan Juan Il. Nice stiff left hand out of that southpaw stance for Andrade.
Oh, Andrade's doing a good job of circling to that side and cutting off the angles and just creating some beautiful spots to hit him.
Plenty of movement, high on the balls of the feet, both men here. Southpaw versus Orthodox. Nice high check there from Andrade.
Yeah, Andrade spoke to me a lot about his IQ, and you can already see the damage that's starting to develop on the face of Quan Juan Il.
Between the eyes, like there's a target painted there for Andrade to go after.
Andrade is.
Oh, buddy, kick! That's good for Lineker! Knockout for Real! Haggerty! Wonder Boy! Does it again! Quan Juan Il back quickly. Take a look at this. Perfectly placed liver kick. The delayed reaction tells the story. The entire body. One of the most painful ways to get knocked out. Severe and
I'm the new king! Ah! I'm the king!
Southpaw stance on Andrade, long reach on him. Overhand right early from Pakatu. Andrade very straight up in his stance, dragging the chin very high.
Yeah, we know that. That's his style. You know, he's also got 40 professional Muay Thai wins, so he's been competing and striking a long time. He is slick on his feet, but he kind of just relies on his eyes to do so. Look at Jeremy rushing forward, throwing big hands.
Elbow on the inside there from Pakatu. Andrade unfazed, head movement from the Brazilian, circles off counterclockwise, takes that inside leg hit, snaps out a jab.
It's important for Pakatu to utilize those leg kicks, try to slow down that movement and that footwork that's coming from Andrade.
Right hand lead there from Pakatu, fell short, not so the jab of Andrade. Pakatu just dipping the feet in the water, dips the ankle around the back of the neck there of Andrade.
It was interesting to hear Andrade break down Team Lakai's Wushu. He says they're all very similar, they're slow, they hit hard, but they just aren't gonna be able to handle his speed. And that's what he's hoping for here against Pakatu, and he's utilizing that jab really well.
Good sliding jab off the lead at right hand there from Andrade. Cracks the round kick to the lower right ribs. Fake here from Andrade. Body shot, Pakatu gets caught, and it's over. We told you, he has set the world on fire. He's done it again.
I'm the new king! I'm the king! Come on, get it!
What a start.
light on his feet, moving in and out. Lee Kai Win throws the leg kick, timing well.
You see the long arms, the reach on that lead arm of Andrade. Lee Kai Win can hook him over the top, so Fabrizio's going to be careful. Driving takedown from Lee Kai Win, and Fabrizio back on his feet, put against the wire now.
Something new coming from Lee Kai Win to open the match with a takedown as he drops down, changes levels, and puts down Andrade. Staying true to his words, saying he wanted to mix in the wrestling for this matchup because he knows just how good Andrade is on his feet. I believe he's changing things up by utilizing the wrestling.
Two takedowns inside the opening minute from Lee Kai Win. Andrade breaks off. No chance for the elbows or the knees from the Muay Thai stylist. Back to center circle. Good jab to kangaroo combination there from Andrade. Trying to push Lee Kai Win to the outside. There's the hook I spoke about earlier. Lee Kai Win can thread that over the top of the lead glove all night long. And as Mitch said, those gloves are low on the Brazilian.
Nice left hand by Lee Kai Win. Let's see what Andrade has to do here on the feet. He's coming forward. He's controlling that center circle well. Lee Kai Win's got good timing so far.
It's three hooks landed in the space of the last 40 seconds from Lee Kai Win, and it spells danger for Andrade.
Andrade's timing that left hand pretty well, though, on the counter shot. I think he's just trying to figure out how Lee Kai, he told me that Lee Kai Win overextends on his punches, but it looks like Lee Kai Win's keeping his feet underneath him pretty well when he's throwing these hooks.
Good step through knee, belly button through the back there from Fabrizio.
Chiavelli, you told me on the walk, you were like, there's no way this one goes three rounds. And the way these guys are touching each other, I'm starting to buy into your prediction pretty quickly.
Licking jab, right hand, southpaw stance, cutting side kick to the knee there from Andrade. Covers up against that hook, there's the Brazilian. Another one there from Lee Kai Win.
Lee Kai Win's got to be careful. He comes in very well, but after he throws that combination, he's kind of standing there. He needs to circle back out. He got touched right there by Andrade's right hand.
Good Andrade, the power hand, the left hand.
I like to see Lee Kai Win go back to those takedowns, start mixing things up. The longer this stays on the feet, the better timing Andrade is going to start to showcase, especially with that left hand.
That reach of Fabrizio is starting to cause problems now as he touches the bridge of the nose, the damaged bridge of the nose of Lee Kai Win. There's the hook from Lee Kai Win. Not getting on the inside as frequently as he was early on in the round, though, the Chinese athlete.
Because of the backwards movement coming from Andrade, he can hit you off the back foot, and that's dangerous, especially when you have the striking capabilities of Andrade. Lee Kai Win's got to be careful coming forward like that.
It was one of the specialties of Brandon Vera and his reign as a heavyweight champion of the world, the ability to drift away and hook his opponents. The fadeaway hook, and we know that Andrade possesses a similar weapon. Overhand right to left hook there from Lee Kai Win. Andrade peppering with the lead hand, trying to sit Lee Kai Win at the end of his glove and then employ the left-hand powerhouse.
That jab's coming off of Andrade really quick, but that knee hurt him.
Beautiful Muay Thai.
Defend yourself, Lou, defend yourself.
Beautiful Muay Thai, they almost folded him like origami. Can Andrade finish Lee Kai Win here in the first with 53 seconds to go, another knee.
It's going back to the knee.
Andrade all over Lee Kai Win here.
Let's see Andrade go to the body now. Lee Kai Win was hurt with those knees and he did it again. Now he's starting to touch him. You can see the hands of Lee Kai Win starting to come down. Lee Kai Win's got to move. Might want to shoot here in the last 30.
Those knees just careening into the right side of the body, to that liver section, to the bottom right rib cage, the high kick there, and he's tagged him again. Lee Kai Win's on rubber legs. He may be ripe for the picking. Down he goes, and it's goodnight, Irene. Fabrizio Andrade stays undefeated. And you better believe he is coming for the entire bantamweight division.
Hey, Catch! Catch!
Target, I dare say, Dragon, for Abelardo to go for.
Yeah, Abelardo has got a monstrous overhand right, so I'd expect him to test the chin of Andrade, but Andrade is a highly skilled striker, so I expect him to understand very well what's going on. Beautiful 1-2 combination landed by Andrade.
Andrade called the Wonder Boy, pro record of 3-2, one knockout, one sub. Comes in off back-to-back wins in China last year, the young Brazilian. Abelardo, 19-7 with 3 submissions, 11 knockouts, a massive 74% finishing rate for Mark Fairtex Abelardo. Winner of one Warrior Series. Has lots of fan support in both New Zealand and the Philippines. Was born in New Zealand to Filipino parents, Mark Abelardo. As Andrade on the outside here, catches the leg. We're going to take the Brazilian down. Posts up on that left arm, but can't avoid going down. Back to his feet, Andrade. Nice short knee to the midsection. Overhook on the right arm of Fabricio Andrade. And this is certainly setting a good pace in the opening 90 or so seconds, Mitch.
Yeah, Andrade was able to pop right back up off that takedown attempt from Abelardo. Andrade's been working hard at Tiger Muay Thai, trying to transition into mixed martial arts with the Hickman brothers out there. And he's doing a good job so far of just kind of understanding the range of Abelardo and keeping up the end of some of these punches.
Hands up. Abelardo's gone 3-2 in his last 5. Checks the low kick, comes out looping with the hands. That's where Andrade has to protect the jaw. The jaw that's very high in the air. Abelardo cuts off the ring, shoots in for a clinch up. Overhooks that left arm, does Andrade. Now tries to get the arm underneath there. Certainly a interesting joust here in the opening round. Abelardo, who hasn't won by submission since 2013 against Andre Paulette. In fact, early in his career, Abelardo was known for his subs, not his knockout power. His first 4 pro matches, he won 3 by submission, all in the second round. Andrade, long legs, completely different physiques between these two athletes. The stockier, more muscular build of Abelardo, the long, lean beanpole of Fabricio Andrade. Nice jab there from the Brazilian. Originally from Fortaleza in northeastern Brazil. A place that has also produced the likes of Thiago Alves, Hermes Franca, and Marcus Aurelio. A little bit of a loop on that lead hand out of southpaw stance there from Andrade Mitch.
Yeah, I like how Abelardo's mixing things up a little bit. He's got Andrade up against the ropes a couple of times, just kind of testing inside that clinch, giving him a couple good looks. Abelardo likes to strike with people. He likes to keep that pressure on. And Andrade looks really calm and relaxed in there.
Nice inside leg kick there from the Brazilian. Flicks out a punt kick. Can't really call it a push kick or a front kick. To do that, you've got it. Hit with the ball of the foot, splay the toes, and push forward. A punt kick is more what it looks like if you were kicking a football. Good left hand, and then the jab from the southpaw Brazilian. Abelardo weaves underneath the hooks here. Abelardo, who began training in karate as a 10-year-old under his dad, who was a third-degree black belt in Sinkatsu, a Filipino combat karate art. Mitch, you're in the Philippines. What do you know about Sinkatsu?
Not very much, but I do know it's got a mix of everything. A little bit of grappling, a little bit of striking, a lot of self-defense techniques. But I do like how Andrade is keeping that jab out, keeps touching him with things. Beautiful straight right hand there landed by Andrade.
High kick from Andrade, looking to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Overhand right there from Abelardo. Built like a tank, Abelardo, and when he wants to throw, my word, can he throw with power? Trying to launch the heavy artillery, though officially it hasn't stuck. But I know you're going to say it. You're itching to say it. So what's the nickname you came up for it?
Elbow Lardo.
Yeah,
he throws elbows, heavy elbows coming from Abelardo, and he throws them with bad intentions.
We'll put it to the fans. Let us know on Twitter, at One Championship. Do you like Abelardo or Nate? Now, Mitch is right, though. If Abelardo gets on the inside and launches those elbows, particularly the crossing elbow, the horizontal elbow, off the right arm, it could be devastating. Jumping knee from Andrade. Nicely done there from the Brazilian striker. The Wonder Boy does have a kickboxing record of 28-1. He's a Brazilian and South American Muay Thai champion. Single leg here from Abelardo. They go to canvas. What does Andrade look to do from here, Dragon?
Oh, he defended beautifully. He jumps on the back. The choke is under the chin. This might be a wrap, folks. It's tight. It's
tight. Can he find it? Can he find it? The Wonder Boy. Figure four around the body. Abelardo with a hole in the bottom. It's good night, Irene. Abelardo's gone to sleep. Open the fridge. He is out cold. Fabricio Andrade, welcome to One Championship.
Wow, that was impressive. He looked stellar on the feet, but the minute he had the opportunity, he jumped on the back of Abelardo, sunk in that choke, and put him to sleep. At just 22 years old, the Wonder Boy makes a huge statement inside One Championship on a massive card on a huge night. What a deep choke. Abelardo, there was no tap. He was going to take a nap. That was absolutely brilliant. The Wonder Boy making a statement.
10 seconds.
In a strictly striking contest, he wants to mix things up, force Andrade to grapple with him, and then just work on draining his energy. Wants to tire him out and get this into the later rounds.
Andrade, 9 years younger than Shoko Sato, gives up the experience inside the circle. Not striking experience, however, with that great Muay Thai career. Both men just dipping their toes in the proverbial waters to start this one. You see Andrade trying to cut off the movement of Shoko Sato. Sato would love to get a crack at the world title held by Bibi Fernandez.
Andrade is doing a beautiful job of countering Shoko Sato right now. You can see a big grin just spread across his face when Shoko Sato threw that leg kick, and Andrade was able to answer it with a two-punch combination.
Andrade fakes. Shoko went in for a single leg there. Nice uppercut on the inside. Chance for the knees here. Crossing elbow. Nice Muay Thai technique from Andrade.
I like how he used that frame off the collarbone. Beautiful little elbow right there inside the clinch from Andrade.
Those elbows can slice and dice if Sato's not careful. Heel kick there from Sato to the hamstring. Elbows open here again for Andrade.
Andrade's been working hard on his wrestling over the break, and it looks like Shoko Sato's dropping down, going after a leg now. Andrade seems wide to it. He's scrambling around, ends up on top, and Shoko Sato ends up on his back. Shoko Sato elevates and transitions beautifully into an arm bar, but Andrade pulls his arm out, knew that was coming. Both these guys are very tricky, but Shoko Sato is just trying to attack at every corner. Now he's going after a leg lock. Andrade needs to stay tight here. He doesn't want to allow Shoko Sato to start extending it. Good job, good defense from Andrade.
Shoko Sato looking to make it 7 finishes in a row. Unable to do it though inside the opening half of the round. Back to the preferred position for Fabricio Andrade.
See, that's where Soko Sato is so dangerous. It's inside that clinch when he presses you up against the wall. He's looking to take your back. You don't know where he's going to go. And he just showcased right there that he will drop down and then attack your lower body, too.
Double leg attempt there from Soko Sato. Glancing right hand from Andrade. We speak about the Muay Thai and the striking technique of Andrade, but let's not forget that Soko Sato has finished his opponent via knockout in over half of his wins. He's got powerful strikes. Are these takedown attempts a little sloppy from Sato at the moment, Dragon?
I don't think they're sloppy. I just think Andrade is defending very well. And then as soon as he gets a little bit of space and Sato starts to separate, he fires in that left hand and he scores at every occasion.
Drifts off into the lead hand. You can see Andrade was at southpaw stance. Now switches back to orthodox, the Brazilian. Good exchange in the center of the circle there. Leg kick misses for Sato. 1:15 remains, an intriguing opening round here.
Sato did land a beautiful little right hand off of that break.
Outside leg kick from Andrade, looking to break into the top five. Number five position held by Shuya Kamakubo of Japan. Switches to southpaw again to Andrade. Now back to orthodox. He's been switching stance continually in this opening round, Dragon.
Yeah, he likes that. He likes to give his opponents just different looks, not allow them to get comfortable, and just put a little bit different tempo behind these things. And that's one thing you're seeing. He can flurry, and then he can also go off his back foot. Andrade is a very talented striker. There's a nice little takedown attempt by Soko Sato, but Andrade was able to counter with a knee, and then again, even though he's off balance, he still maneuvered backward to defend the takedown.
Little elbow off the left arm there from Andrade as he was using well in the earlier part of the round. Does have a combined kickboxing and Muay Thai record of 40-3 with 17 knockouts. Fabricio Andrade.
10 seconds.
A right hand was a beauty there from Soko Sato. And another one from Sato. Opens up like a house on fire now. And they're swinging at each other in the final second. Coming to you from Singapore. And there's that crossing left elbow from Andrade again that won him in striking superiority in the first round on Ace Rich Franklin's scorecard. Overhand right to a left hook there from Andrade. Could he possibly beat the number two in the world? It would be considered an upset, but so far so good from Andrade. Jab from the Brazilian.
It would catapult him into the rankings if he gets past Soko Sato. And he's doing good so far, but I am seeing that right hand land repeatedly from Soko Sato. So he has to be very careful about that. And the veteran knows how to close. He knows how to finish you. You give him one opportunity and Soko Sato can get it done. But Andrade's not giving him that opportunity, especially in these clinches. Watch, Andrade's gonna start to fire as soon as he gets a little bit of separation.
Undefeated in his last six, Soko Sato, a record dating back to January 2018. Only two losses by sub through 55 career bouts. Last submission loss way back over 8 years ago.
Look at this control, Michael. The way Fabricio is controlling inside the clinch. He's trying to manipulate the right hand of Soko Sato. And as soon as he gets that, he starts slamming those elbows in. Soko Sato was like, I don't want any more of those bows. And he drops down to guard.
Andrade continues to switch stance, trying to confound Soko Sato. Sato went for a body shot. Instructions coming from both corners. Portuguese of Andrade, and Japanese of Soko Sato. Sato drifting into the, well, what do you call the power side with the guy who switches this much?
Yeah, and that's the beauty of Andrade's style, is he will keep changing things up, and it's hard for you to get a beat on what he's doing because of those stance changes. But he seems to do his best work out of this southpaw position.
Almost halfway through the contest, after a very impressive opening round from Fabricio Andrade. Beautiful flurry from both men in the final 10 seconds. Will they put the foot down again here in the second round? Sato led him with the left hand on that occasion. Nice jab, sliding jolt jab to an outside leg kick there from Soko Sato. fake from Andrade, outside leg kick from the Brazilian landed. Overhand right from Andrade. Uppercut almost put the chin through the top of the head. Beautifully done from Shoko Sato.
Yeah, Sato can score with that right hand. He lands the overhand right, and he just landed with that uppercut too. Andrade's got to keep his wits about him because that right hand comes with some serious force.
Fake there from Sato. High kick from the Japanese warrior. Three punches missed, not so the knee to the midsection. Well done there from young Andrade. Will he fire the elbow off the left hand here? Left arm, I should say. No, it's a looping hook off the right. And back to orthodox stance for Andrade. Now to southpaw stance. Skipping outside leg kick from Shoko Sato. Lots of movement here, Mitch, from Sato.
Yeah, and it's hard for Andrade to get really an accurate beat on him because he has this constant movement. He's not staying still, and he lunges forward. I think he just slammed into the...
You're thinking maybe he'll drop or do something different, like he just shot in there, and so it throws you off.
We'll get Rich's thoughts again between rounds if we get that far, as they clinch up to start the recommence here.
Wow, Shoko Sato was in deep on that takedown. Great defense coming from Andrade as he tries to pull him to the ground, but Andrade is hard to control. He's going to try to control that right hand of Shoko Sato, spin him around, put his back against the wall, and then start firing off those elbows.
A spinning back elbow from Shoko Sato. How do you do? It came close. Nice sliding jolt jab again there from Shoko Sato. Body shot to outside thigh kick. He's trying to go kleptomaniac. A flicking jab there from Andrade. That spinning elbow was superb. Andrade. Shoko Sato. Some spectacular technique at the end of the second round from the Japanese number two ranked in the world. Lots of movement early on in the third and final. Still anyone's for the taking, Dragon.
Yeah, but we're seeing exactly what Shoko Sato told me he wanted to do. He wanted to wear on Andrade, slow him down, take his energy from him. And he felt that Andrade could just not keep up the pace that he did in the first. And he's going to slowly start to break. And that's where Shoko Sato can find the finish with ground and pound or a submission. But here, he needs to get out of these positions. He's got to score heavily because you're starting to see Andrade start to turn things up in the striking because he realizes just how close this is.
Went for the big uppercut, missed the target. Good counter there from Andrade. A loss for Shoko Sato tonight would be debilitating. It would completely derail his aspirations for a title tilt. Another flurry forward, little knee on the inside from Andrade. Use of that Muay Thai so well does the 23-year-old from Brazil.
Yeah, he really likes the overhook and then controlling of the hand. He just does a really good job inside that clinch of scoring points.
Right hand lead from Shoko Sato as Fabricio continues to switch stance on the Japanese warrior. Good outside leg kick, clipping left hand there. Do you see any, you were saying before that Shoko Sato wanted to get Fabricio to deep water, try and tire out the 23-year-old. Do you see any signs of that, Mitch?
I saw a little bit of it in the second round, but Andrade's turned it up here in the third. You can see how he is putting more combinations together. He's just not throwing one shot. He's not allowing Shoko Sato to go first. He's doing the aggressive moves forward, but there's a beautiful little trip takedown, almost an Soto Gotti coming from Shoko Sato, which is an outside trip. Look at that. Spun around, took the back. That is vintage Shoko Sato right there.
Can he make it? Seven finishes in a row. He's going to spill at the back door. Here is he, Shoko Sato.
I look for an arm bar, but Andrade knew exactly what he was going to do.
Half a round remaining. Shoko Sato trying for a spectacular finish, Dragon.
That's still going to score, though. That shows a little bit of ground control, even though it wasn't on the ground.
Ground control, even though it wasn't on the ground. Okay.
least you're honest, Dragon. At least you're honest.
Back to center circle.
What are you going to call it? Standing grappling control?
Why not? That works. Good elbow. Oh. Left elbow has been a treat the entire contest.
Especially to that side, the strong side of Shoko Sato. The way he gets that overhook and then starts firing up. Look at the damage just wearing on Shoko Sato's face.
Cut on the side of the head of Shoko Sato. Fakes here from Andrade out of southpaw stance. Evades the high kick, countered with low kicks to Sato. This one may go down to the wire. I do not fancy being a judge.
Man, even if you're just pretending to be a judge on TV, like Rich Franklin's doing, this is going to be so tough to score. Look at Andrade now going after the legs. Ah, there's a heel hook attempt. Shoko Sato knows what he's doing. Beautiful float over there to end up on the back.
So carrying Shoko Sato like a backpack at the moment. 1 minute 10 remaining. Shoko Sato trying to find a finish and make it 7 in a row. Wants to send a message to John Lineker that he wants number one in the division.
Almost attempt a suit live stretch right there as he dropped down to stretch out the leg of Fabricio Andrade, but Andrade knows what's going on as he turns into the guard of Shoko Sato.
A what stretch?
Suleve.
Suleve stretch.
Nasty. Had the back, drop down and take the leg. Nasty.
Wow. I learn something new every day. Back to their feet, 35 seconds on the clock now. Lots of damage on the face of Shoko Sato. High kick there from Andrade. Southpaw stance again from the young Brazilian. Who will put the foot down? Spinning back elbow again from Shoko Sato. Did not connect. 20 seconds now. Oh. Two punch, three punch combination from Andrade at full extension on those very long arms. Shoko Sato comes forward. Andrade circling out of the way of danger. Left hook there, but caught him with the inside of the glove. End of the round, we go to the towels, we go to the judges.